Hi, my name is Peter from URender. In this video, I will show you how to work with displacement textures. A displacement texture is a grayscale texture, where every gray value equals a height value that is going to be displaced outside or inside a geometry. Sounds complicated, but it's simple. Let's try this simple texture with basic shapes and gradients on the borders. The first thing you have to do is to activate Enable Displacement in the render settings. Then you have to assign a height map in the displacement channel of the URender material. The height value lets you set the maximum distance of the displacement. The strength slider can be used to adjust or even invert the displacement. The subdivision level defines for how many times the geometry is going to be subdivided. Smoothing lets the shading become softer and is a good way if you use organic displacement maps or if you want to get rid of noise that is caused by the displacement texture. Before we come to the displacement types, I want to show you the difference between an 8-bit and 16-bit displacement map. Here I already use a 16-bit file that has a lot more gradient steps compared to an 8-bit texture. So let's render the current scene into the picture viewer and load the same texture, but this time as 8-bit JPEG. There is a huge difference, especially if using low smoothing values. We can increase the smoothing value to get a cleaner result, but this also would smooth fine details of the displacement map. So I recommend to use 16-bit displacement maps. In the displacement type, there are a couple of modes you can use. Most of time, you will need intensity or intensity centered. When using intensity, the black values of the used texture defines areas that are not going to be displaced, and white areas are going to be displaced at maximum. So as you can see, the base of the plane is not moving because it's black in the texture. Intensity centered means that a gray value of 50% is not going to be displaced. Darker values are displaced inside and brighter values outside. Let's test a more complex displacement map. You can find fantastic displacement maps on Substance Source, by the way. I also will create a spotlight so we can see some shadows from our displaced geometry. Now let's increase and optimize the subdivision levels to get a fast but detailed result. I recommend to set the geometry subdivisions as low as possible and let the displacement subdivision levels do their job. If you look to that element, we see an oval-shaped displacement. I think that would look better if the shape is more like a cycle. You can simply adjust that by increasing the gamma value of the texture. I want to show you once more the difference between the 16-bit texture I already use here and the 8-bit version. Now that everything is set up fine, let's add the other textures. Let's create another primitive, like a cylinder. To get a consistent displaced geometry, I recommend to set the segments in a way that the quads are nearly quadratic. Of course, the displaced geometry fully interacts with ambient occlusion. If you use many different displacement maps in your scene, there can be a huge amount of polygons. If the scene slows down in live mode, you don't need to decrease the subdivision level in every material. Just open the render settings and in the basic tab you find limit displacement steps. Activate it and set the maximum displacement steps to limit the subdivision level of all your materials. Altogether, displacement maps are a fantastic way to add more details to your scenes. Thanks for watching.